Hey guys, I'm going to be doing a part two of my eyeshadow palette collection. I'm just going to be going over the different palettes that I own and giving you guys my thoughts. Starting off with the Wet n Wild Trios, this one is in Spoiled Brat. Now I've had this one for years, but I never reached for it. I think when I bought it, I thought the color story was kind of unique. However, I never reach for hot pinks, so I don't really like it. And then this black sparkly shade is just a little bit too charcoal and chalky for my taste. However, I think the color story is unique. The next one I have is actually my favorite of the trios. This one is Walking on Eggshells. I love this one. I used to use this like every day. One thing I have to say with it, though, is I hate how the packaging breaks so easily on these. So that was disappointing. However, the formula in this is the best. It is like my favorite formula out of the Wet n Wild ones. Now, they did change the formula, so I am disappointed in that because I tried the newer formula that looks more like this palette. And I didn't really like it. However, I saw that they changed it again, so I might try the newest formula, and I'm really hoping that that is more close to this one. The next palette I have to mention is the Hooked on Vinyl. Now, this one is stunning. I love this palette. I never reach for it because I rarely reach for like trio palettes anymore or quads. I mostly reach for my big palettes. However, this one is beautiful. It's like a beautiful fall palette. So I think this is one of their best ones that they came out with. And then finally, I have the Comfort Zone palette. You guys, this is nasty. Okay, so this is nail polish that got all over my palette. So I am really disappointed about that. However, this formula is amazing. Unfortunately, this is what happens because their palette or their packaging breaks so easily. So it's crushed. But I have to say this formula again is just the best. So like this shade right here is a beautiful duochrome teal. Look at that. It's like a, I don't know what you might call it. It's like almost like a greenish red shade. And it's so stunning. This is my favorite shade. However, this lighter green is also really, really beautiful. So to me, those are the standout shades for this palette. And whenever I want to reach for a green look, I always reach for this one. I'm just disappointed that it just shattered so easily. I do want to show you guys, though, I got the newer version. So I got this version of Comfort Zone, but again, it just didn't come close for me in the formula of the shimmers. I was just a little bit disappointed in that. Like this green right here. It's okay, but I just don't think it was nearly as pretty as the last one. However, the mattes in here are really nice, and I do like that this one has mattes, whereas this one doesn't. And I find that a couple of the shimmers do perform better in this palette. And the Comfort Zone are my favorite out of the bigger palettes that they have. However, they have these two other ones. So this one is Rosé in the Air. It's supposed to be the dupe for Modern Renaissance. I really like this palette. The colors in here are pretty. However, I do reach for the Modern Renaissance more because it has more shades that I really love. And I think the formula I like better, honestly, even though this palette is a really good deal. So I like it, but it's not my favorite. And then the next palette I have from them is the Not a Basic Peach. This one I reach for the least. However, I want to start doing tutorials with this palette because it is really pretty. And I do like the orangey tones in here. Moving on to the NYX Smoky palette. So I got this one kind of like, I want to say a few years ago. I'm not a huge fan of it, to be honest. I used to be really into just wearing these dark navy blue shades all over my lid. I don't know why. But it was not the prettiest look. And I find that the formula in here is not the best. So this one was kind of a dud for me. The next palette I want to mention to you guys, this one is the Revlon one. Oh, look how gross this looks. I forgot which one it is. Sorry. But it's like the cream formula. It's called Not Just Nudes. And this one looks disgusting. So, yeah, I'm not a huge fan of these. Actually, I did used to like this a lot. But I would, if I did get this palette again, I would definitely repurchase a new one because I've had this literally since 8th grade. That's how old this is. I used to love it back then. I do still like it. I find the colors are very pretty, and I used to be so into that cream formula. But the one thing I don't like about it is it really creases easily because it's a cream formula. However, these colors were beautiful, and it was a nice way to get into wearing eye makeup. Next ones I have to mention are, these are two kind of palettes that my boyfriend got for me. This is the Love Me Makeover Essentials. Now, I don't really reach for these that much. It has like a blush. The blush is pretty. I actually do want to do some more looks with this, with a blush and then this like contour kind of bronzy shade. I like the idea of it. However, these little like shimmer shadows are actually really pretty. They have like different colors that I think are really nice. They have this really pretty, this shade, which is kind of like a silver. And they have this shade, which is kind of like a taupey shade. And then they have two other shades. They have this like goldish shade, which is really pretty. And then this purple shade that I'll show you in a second. This one is my favorite.